Dr. Chandra Medical College Coaching by CPC. Here is your tutor Boma Devachandra Shikran from Abu Dhabi. Today we are going to see about alcohol, tobacco and drug use during pregnancy, childbirth and the preparing. First, the alcohol use. If the patient is using alcohol that is complicating the pregnancy, childbirth and puerperium, then we have to code primary diagnosis as O99.31 alcohol use complicating pregnancy, childbirth and puerperium. And the secondary diagnosis is from F10 category, alcohol related disorders. And the second one is tobacco use. If the patient is using tobacco during pregnancy, then the principal diagnosis would be O99.33 smoking complicating pregnancy, childbirth and puerperium. And secondary diagnosis is F17 nicotine dependence, F17 category nicotine dependence code. And the third one is drug use during pregnancy. Principal diagnosis is O99.32 drugs complicating pregnancy, childbirth and puerperium. And the secondary diagnosis is F11 to F16 category and F18 to F19 category, that is to identify the manifestation of drug use. The next topic is poisoning, toxic effect, adverse effect and underdosing in pregnant patient, which means any drugs which causes allergic to a pregnant patient or which can be, if the drugs taken overdose, then it will be poison. If it is taken underdose, then also it will be poison. In that cases, how will we code? The principal diagnosis is 098.2 injury, poisoning and certain other consequences of external causes complicating pregnancy, childbirth and puerperium. The secondary diagnosis is injury, poisoning, toxic effect and adverse effect code. And the next is normal delivery code OAD. Encounter for full term and complicated delivery. Full term, there is no complication in pregnancy and delivery, means then the principal diagnosis OAT. It should not be appended with chapter 15 codes for additional diagnosis. It can be appended with any other chapter codes for additional diagnosis according to the condition of the patient. Uncomplicated delivery with resolved antepartum complication, which means the any kind of complication is there, but at the time of discharge there is no complication, means then we have to assign principal diagnosis as OAT. And the outcome of delivery is principal diagnosis as OAT and the secondary diagnosis Z37.0 single live birth code we have to assign. The next topic is peripartum and the postpartum periods. The peripartum and the postpartum period means the postpartum is immediately after delivery and 6 weeks following delivery. And the peripartum is from the last month of pregnancy to 5 months of postpartum. And the complications of peripartum and postpartum period is it develops, postpartum complication occurring within 6 weeks period. And the pregnancy related complication after 6 weeks period, which is after postpartum period, if any complication, pregnancy related complication develops, then we can use chapter 15 codes to describe that complication after peripartum and postpartum period. And admission for routine postpartum care following delivery outside hospital. If the delivery occurs outside hospital, the mother is admitted for only postpartum care, then we have to assign Z39.0 encounter for care and examination of mother immediately after delivery code. And the pregnancy associated cardiomyopathy. Usually it is noticed in third trimester of the pregnancy and it will develop even after the pregnancy, then it is called as postpartum cardiomyopathy. For this the code is O90.3 pregnancy associated cardiomyopathy code we have to assign. The next topic is code O94. The code O94 is for sequelae code. Sequelae means, you know, the late effects of any condition. Here the O94 describes sequelae complication of pregnancy, childbirth and puerperium. It is used in the initial complication of pregnancy which develops the sequelae, develops sequelae which requires care and treatment in future. and it can be used any time after initial postpartum period, and it should be sequenced like all sequelae codes, which followed by the code describing the complication of sequelae. And the next topic is termination of pregnancy and spontaneous abortion. Here the principal diagnosis is Z33.2 encounter for elective termination of pregnancy, and secondary diagnosis is Z37 outcome of delivery. The next topic is retained product of conception following an abortion. Here we can assign any codes in this O03.4 and O07.4 category according to the condition of the patient. O03.4 is for incomplete spontaneous abortion without complication, and O07.4 is for failed attempted termination of pregnancy without complication. And suppose if the complication occurs during the incomplete spontaneous abortion and termination of pregnancy, then we have to assign code from category O03 and or O07 instead of assigning these two codes, O03.4 and O07.4 codes. The topic is complication leading to abortion. If there is any complication which leads to abortion, then we have to assign chapter 50 code as the additional code to identify the complication of pregnancy. It should be combined with the code category O04, O07 and O08. And the next topic, abuse in a pregnant patient. It can be either a physical abuse or sexual abuse or psychological abuse. The codes are O98.3, physical abuse complicating pregnancy, childbirth and puerperium, and O98.4 is for sexual abuse complicating pregnancy, childbirth and puerperium. O98.5 is for psychological abuse complicating pregnancy, childbirth and puerperium. There is a difference between physical and psychological. Physical means it causes injury to the body of the pregnant woman. But psychological means it's a like kind of mental abuse, and these codes should be sequenced first and followed by the appropriate codes to identify if the patient is having any current injury due to physical, sexual or psychological abuse. So this is the chapter 15 coding guidelines. This is the end of the chapter 15 coding guidelines. If you are having any doubts in chapter 15 coding guidelines, do comment in the comment section or you can personal mail me. I hope you all like the video. If you like the video, please do like, comment and share. And if you are still not subscribed our channel, kindly subscribe our channel and press the bell icon near to the subscribe button. Then only you will get all the notification of our channel. Thank you from Bhumadevi Chandrasekaran.